I'm officially ready to declare vampire movies are back. Now, recently I've seen quite a few vampire movies, and all of them have been really good. And I have to say that Night Teeth is a fun vampire movie. And I have a very simple formula here. If my girl Megan Fox is in the movie, I'm watching it. This formula works, and the math checks out. So let's get to the ratings right quick. I rate this a one-time watch, but this can easily be pushed up to an at-your-collection. I would have made it an instant at-your-collection if Megan Fox was in the movie more than one scene. And let's face it, if she's in 50% of any movie, it is a must-have. Okay, I admit, it's my fantasy, not yours, so be quiet. So what is Night Teeth? Night Teeth follows the story of a guy named Benny. And Benny is our final guy in this movie. Benny seems to have all the qualities of a final girl, it's just he's a guy. He's not like his friends. He doesn't sleep around. In fact, I think he's a virgin in this movie. At least it's heavily implied, so. He's studious. He does all his schoolwork. He gets good grades. The movie even implies that Benny doesn't even drink. And if you follow the nature of a final girl or a final guy, they're usually this altruistic person that kind of stands out in the cast. Now, Benny's aspirations is to be this rapper and producer, as well as getting good grades in school. And Benny is trying to use his music to upgrade his family's financial wealth. Now, Benny's half-brother, Jay. Now, Jay happens to be the leader of this secret underground vampire hunter gang. And Jay's on a revenge mission to get back and kill the vampires who kidnapped his girlfriend. And since Jay is going to be going on his mission, that means he's going to have to take off work. And so he tasks Benny to take his place at work. And to make things a bit more clear, Jay is this Uber for like the rich elites. And while Benny is posing as Jay, picks up these two new clients, Blair and Zoe, Benny is now tasked to take these girls anywhere they want to go before sunup. But what Benny doesn't know is that Blair and Zoe are vampires. But there are events that unfold that allow Benny to find out these girls' true nature. But an unforeseen romance starts to begin between Benny and Blair. And that unforeseen romance gets in the way of the girls' plan, which is to use Benny and later kill him. Coupled with the fact that there is a brooding war between two rival vampire gangs. And those events lead up to the eventual capture of Benny brothers, Jay. Jay is captured by none other than Victor. Victor is the boyfriend of Zoe and the boss of both Zoe and Claire. But Victor is also the leader of a major rival vampire gang, making him the ultimate mastermind of the girls' scheme. So let's get a little clarity here. So basically, Benny is hired by the girls, but is eventually kidnapped once he finds out that they are vampires. So they're not letting him go anywhere. But Blair seems to fall in love with Benny, and that makes her plan for Zoe and her to use him and kill him a lot more difficult. But Victor's plan is to capture Jay by using Benny as bait. And the reason why Victor is doing this is because he wants his gang to be the one true vampire gang in the entire city. But as the events unfold, Benny realizes that he has to now save his brother Jay and kind of nurture his romance with Claire in hopes that she'll help him out. And Blair, on the other hand, must choose between Benny or her best friend, Zoe, who is the only friend she actually ever known. So decisions must be made and alliances will be formed in this movie. And I really like this movie because it really brings a cool factor back to the vampire mythos. And while you'll be rooting for Blair to do the right thing, you'll notice that both she and Zoe add almost this cool vibe, sort of like what Kiefer Sullivan did to vampires images in the 80s. They're doing it in this version. In fact, I would compare this movie to sort of like The Lost Boys. There's a lot of elements of The Lost Boys in this movie. And trust me, Zoe and Blair are every bit as cool and attractive as Kiefer Sullivan was in the 80s with The Lost Boys. These girls are cool. They are ruthless. And they have that attraction factor that makes you want to know more about them as characters. I would say that this movie is more nuanced than many critics give it credit for. I truly believe you will watch this movie and have fun with it. And don't sleep on this movie. It is a pleasant watch, and it's one that I believe you will be watching over and over again.